In this lesson, I'm going to cover virtual private networks and AWS Direct Connect. So we often want to connect our corporate data centers or offices with the AWS cloud. And of course, there's a couple of ways to do this. One is what's called a site-to-site VPN, a virtual private network. The other is Direct Connect. So we're going to have a look at those two in this particular lesson and see what the differences are. So here we have an on-premises network on the right-hand side, the corporate data center, and that's got its own CIDR block. And then on the left-hand side, we have a VPC. So a VPN is a managed IPsec virtual private network. Now you can create your own software-based VPNs, but what we're talking about here is an AWS managed VPN. So that's a service provided by AWS. And it uses IPsec for encryption. Now with a VPN, we have something called a virtual private gateway, which is on the VPC side. So that's a component that we create within our VPC. So it's deployed in the VPC on AWS side. Then we have the customer gateway. Essentially, this is a component of configuration, if you like, that we create within our VPC, but the actual device itself is, of course, in the corporate data center. So we just have to create some configuration for it in the VPC on the AWS side, but the actual physical device is in the corporate data center and needs to be configured by the local admins there. So that's on the customer side. With these two components, we can then create this encrypted VPN connection over the public internet. It doesn't have to be over the public internet, by the way. For example, you can create an encrypted connection over the top of a Direct Connect connection as well. But in this case, let's just assume that this is across the public internet. Now, this does support static routes and BGP peering and routing. So if you're a network admin, that's going to make a lot of sense to you. We can configure various options for how we propagate routes and configure the routing behavior between the on-premises data center and the VPC. Now, in the VPC, of course, we need to have a route table configuration if we want to be able to route from the VPC to the on-premises network. So in this case, we can see that this private subnet here has a destination of the CIDR block of the corporate data center, and the target is going to be the virtual gateway ID. That's the virtual private gateway. That's now going to allow that outbound connectivity from that private subnet to the corporate data center. Next, we have Direct Connect. So again, we have the AWS cloud, we have a region and a VPC here, and a corporate data center. Now, in between those, we have something called an AWS Direct Connect location. Now, you'll want to find one of these that's relatively close to where your corporate data center is, because you then need to create a connection to that location. Within the Direct Connect location, there's going to be an AWS cage, so that's essentially just a cage that has the AWS devices in it within the data center, and then there's the customer partner cage. So the customer or partner router is going to be on the right-hand side there, and of course the AWS router is in the AWS cage. So what needs to happen to establish connectivity? Firstly, what we need to do is get a DX port assigned in the DX location, okay, so DX for Direct Connect. So that means that when we go in and order a connection from AWS, they are going to provide some information to us, and that information is going to include the port within the DX location that we need to connect to. Then, if we have a presence in that location, we can ask the data center to patch a wire across between our equipment and the AWS equipment. Or alternatively, you use a partner. So use a managed service provider who do have equipment in that location, and they're going to patch between their equipment and yours. Then you need to make sure that you can connect from your customer router in your data center through to the DX location. So there, again, you're probably going to need to speak to a managed service provider to create that connectivity for you. So now we have the cross connect between the two different cages in the DX location, and then the private connection from the data center into that DX location. AWS take care then of establishing the remaining configuration through to the actual VPC itself. A Direct Connect connection is a physical fiber connection to AWS running at 1 Gbps to 100 Gbps. Now you can get lower speed connections from partners as well. So what are the benefits? Well, you get enhanced security. You're using private connectivity into AWS. You get consistent network performance, better speed, better latency and bandwidth and throughput. And then we have lower costs. Now, it's not always lower cost. It really depends on the volume of data and the level of redundancy that you need. In some cases, if you have business critical applications and data traversing across this DX connection, you're going to want to implement multiple DX connections with redundancy throughout, and that's going to get quite expensive. However, if you are transferring large quantities of data, you'll need to do the calculations and have a look at that compared to utilizing internet links and see if it comes out as being cost effective.